land.
Hallelujah. We celebrate. We bless the Most High God because we are not in doubt as to where our pastor is. We are not in doubt as to where our pastor is. He is with his Maker, receiving his crowns. Somebody help me praise God. Somebody help me praise God. Even now, we bless his holy name. You are not praising God like I want you to. Somebody help me praise this God. Somebody help me praise this God. Can I have a louder, louder hallelujah? We celebrate, we celebrate, we celebrate our God. Somebody praise this God. Praise this God. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. You may be seated. Hallelujah. There's going to be a Bible reading by pastor's children, Timilei and Jomiloju. They're going to take the first Bible reading. Encourage them. Hallelujah.
The Bible reading is taken from Psalm 46, verses 1 to 11, and it reads, God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. There's a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of tabernacles of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early.
And verse 6 says, the heathen reached, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge, Selah. Come, behold the works of the Lord, what desolations he hath made in the earth. He makes wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and cuts the spear in sunder. He burns the chariot in fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen, and I will be exalted in the
Good morning, our fathers and mothers. Good morning, church. This poem was written by my brother, Akinka Akinola, and I have the privilege of reading it on the request of pastor's children. It is titled, An Ode to Pastor Taiwo. The battle is over. The victor's cross is won. The last trumpet sounded for God's true son. Leader, shepherd, mentor, and guide. Walking with his children side by side. Humility's heart and passion's pride. A man in whom all could confide. Boundless energy, limitless love. All in service of his God above. of hallelujahs and amens, praises and thanks. Leading by example, he swelled our ranks. For Apostle John, a man in whom there is no guile, he must have known you through the spiritual eye. I feel the fire in animated gesticulation, his very being alive, the Spirit's manifestation. He always said, God has given us all gifts, in our little way, others to lift. I therefore choose the written word, infused albeit by the Spirit's sword, that by this gift I may proclaim a man who had no interest in fame. In early days, he heard the call. Reluctant, he told us, just like Paul. At the height of his profession, the master's voice, now an irresistible heavenly noise. Founder, rock of the fountain of life, a shared root of your departed wife. It all started from a rented hall. The journey's been long, but I'll say it all. Then we progressed and we bought our own property, thinking we had reached the heights of prosperity. But our father owns the cattle and the gold, so even that building soon became old. Eventually, the vision, a befitting edifice, fountain auditorium complete with offices. But you are no longer here with your wit and charm. May your vision not come to harm. Who can your bright white smile forget? Rubbing hands together, zeal and zest. Leaping and dancing, divine acrobatics. Straight from your heart, not theater or tactics. In descriptive prose that capture your essence. Still yet, sir, nothing quite like your presence. If only a fraction of us could speak, our testimony will eclipse the mountain peak. Marriages you have healed, almost broken. Children you have counseled, almost forsaken. He led us men in huddled fellowship, our souls prior in spiritual receivership. But with infectious passion and passing no judgment, we embraced the gospel, both Old and New Testament. Of humble beginnings, he would always say, the luxuries of life he had not, nay. Through dint of hard work and quiet focus, just like Christ, our allocutus. The trials of life we can't comprehend. We see through glass darkly till we meet our end. The first time we wondered, why, Lord, oh why? He told us to stand. Children, don't cry. The second time we grieved a pain so deep, he told us, I say stand, don't weep. Now who is to comfort us in this bewilderment? Our mentor and guide beyond the firmament. But still yet he speaks, if truly he was our teacher. For he always said, we are all God's creatures. Loud and clear, deep vibrant baritone. Do your best before you're called to go home. There are things that threaten even great men's faith, like the laying of a sudden and premature wreath. The scriptures ask, death, where is thy sting? But a joyful song is very hard to sing. To say we are not bowed is to tell a lie. To say we are broken, God forbid, from on high. We soldier on in confident trepidation, though unsure of the certainty of this dislocation. In all this, though, we hold on to one lesson. You taught us always, I am only one person. Men will come and men will go, no matter how much they shine and glow. For you, the final bell has knelled. We bid you, sir, fare thee well. The common end for all of flesh, there is no second earthly refresh. It's time to say the final good night, until we see you one day in glorious light. You've traveled the valley and fear is no more. You are on Jerusalem's verdant, peaceful shore. In your father's house, there are many mansions. Reserved for you is one for his champions. But as long as we live in this body corruptible, our emotions and minds are highly susceptible. So with rigid frame, but a melted heart, tear-drenched eyes, because we are apart, we must acknowledge this massive void. With emotional control like Sigmund Freud. Pastor, father, brother, and friend, we will remember you to the very end.
Hallelujah. Thank you very much, Sister Iwandi Zacchaeus. Now we're going to be privileged to watch a video that is titled, Our General Has Gone Home. Thereafter, the choir will come on and take and the glory, and then a congregational hymn. Thank you.
Pastor Daniel Taiwo Odukoya, the mighty man of war, had his weapons, but they were not carnal, but mighty through God for the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations and every high thing that dared to exalt itself against the knowledge of God. By speaking the word of God, which is the sword of the Spirit, Pastor Taiwo depopulated hell and the kingdoms of iniquity by calling the souls of men out of darkness into the kingdom of God's marvelous light. In the name of Jesus, the name above all names, he rebuked sicknesses, destroyed poverty, and the testimonies that confirmed them. By the submission of his life to God and the total obedience to his calling, Pastor Taiwo shined the light of the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ into the darkness of this world. Because of the life of Pastor Taiwo, multitudes in the valley of decision have become the disciples of Jesus Christ, having received the promised salvation and have been made citizens of the kingdom of heaven. They in turn have gone forth into the world with zeal and power to make disciples of men, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, demonstrating their God-given authority over sickness, over devils, over poverty, and over fear, and all the works of the devil. As it is written, for this reason was the Son of God made manifest, that he might destroy the works of the devil. And we rejoice because our Pastor Taiwo Odukoya, God's general, finished well. And because he finished well, there are multitudes of men, women, and children converted by the words he spoke and the life he lived, going forth to fulfill the scripture that says, this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. For the scripture cannot be broken.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Amen. Please be seated. The second Bible reading for this service is going to be taken by another of Pastor's children, Pastor Mrs. Toby Enoha.
Good afternoon, church. The second Bible reading is from Isaiah 25, verses 8 and 9 in the New King James Version. He will swallow up death forever, and the Lord God will wipe away tears from all faces. The rebuke of his people he will take away from all the earth, and for the Lord has spoken. And it will be said in that day, behold, this is our God. We have waited for him, and he will save us. This is the Lord. We have waited for him. We will be glad and rejoice in his salvation. May the Lord bless the reading of his word.
to the name of the Lord. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Oh, forever, amen. For thine is the kingdom and the power and all the glory forever. And the power and the glory go. Oh.
Hallelujah. You can put those hands together for the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. You may please be seated. Just before we have the next Bible reading, I did make a slight error when I introduced the last Bible reading speaker. I addressed you, Toby, as Mrs., but she is indeed Dr. Mrs. Toby Enoa. Our pastor was so very proud. He spent good money. And she did us all proud. Thank you very much, Dr. Mrs. Toby Enoa. The next Bible reading is going to be taken by yet another of pastor's children. This one needs no introduction. But I will try. Pastor. Star. Jimmy Odukoya to take the next Bible reading.
Hallelujah. Good afternoon, Daddy and Mommy, the pastors, distinguished guests, church. Thank you so much for being here. The Bible reading shall be taken from Romans 8, 35, 37 to 39. And it reads, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulations or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors to him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Amen.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Please put your hands together for this wonderful choir. The choir of the Fountain of Life Church, in case you do not know, are called the Grace Levites. And they are the best choir this side of heaven. Please put it together for them. All our fathers in the faith, please don't be jealous. This is the only thing we have that is the best in the whole world. The Grace Levites. Hallelujah. And our instrumentalists are called the Grace Band. And they are second to none this side of heaven. Hallelujah. We're going to go into a short period of worship that is going to be led by one of Pastor's fruits, an international song string. Her name is Oluchi. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Father, we bless your holy name. We give you all the praise, Jesus. There is no one like you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You are the Lord. Let your name be glorified. You are the Lord. Let your name be glorified. Father, we declare over and over and over and over again, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Lord. Let your name be glorified.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Sister Luchi. Please put your hands together for her. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to have the last Bible reading for this service, and it's going to be taken by Pastor's first child. Pastor, Mrs. Wait. I'm still coming. Sit down. Don't worry. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I have to introduce her specially because she's a songstress. You know what I mean, Shah. She's a soloist. She's a psalmist. She's just plenty. Pastor Mrs. Tolu Ijogun.
Hallelujah. Thank you, sir. Good morning, Mommy. Good morning, Daddy. Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. The last Bible reading will be taken from John 14, 1 to 3. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. May God bless the reading of his word. Amen.
My little bush.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Pastor Tolu. We're going to be going into the word for today. Just before that, I'll have the choir just give us one worship song, but I'm going to introduce the speaker just before you do that. Church, please help me welcome the man that God has prepared to give us the word today, Bishop David Abioye of the Winners Chapel. Thank you, sir. He will come up as the choir does one worship song.
Reign, Jesus, reign. My abortion. Reign, Jesus. Say that you reign, Jesus reign.
Shall we all rise to our feet in honor of Jesus and our beloved pastor? Let us lift up our hands if you can. Give glory to God. If you can, raise your voice a little louder. Just give him the glory due to him. It's a day of celebration. A day of celebration of life. Give him the glory, everybody. Somebody rejoice in the Lord. What a day. What a blessing. What a glory. God's presence is mightily here. Let's honor him. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for this blessed moment in the celebration of life of your servant, co-laborer, father, pastor, and all the positions he occupied while he was here with us. We give you all the glory for his life in the name of Jesus. And now, O Lord, bless us with your word, strengthen our hearts, comfort our souls, give us hope for tomorrow. Let all these and many more blessings be our portion this morning, in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. Please get seated, get excited, everybody, if you can. A big shout to the Lord and a clap unto him as well. Amen. I want to specially count it a privilege this morning before God and before our spiritual father, a great leader of repute across the globe, in the person of Bishop Mike Okonkwo, and our very dear mother, he's had the assignment given to him by God to oversee our co-laborer, Pastor Taiwo Odukoya, and the Fountain of Life Church. I want to thank God for how he has stood very firm and strong in encouraging the church. Sir, we feel very proud and we appreciate your leadership. By privilege also, he directed me to be here to share God's word with us this morning, and that I don't take lightly. Thank you very much, sir. Seated here also this morning, another general, wonderful leader, and a mentor to many, in the person of Pastor Matthew Ashimoluo, we acknowledge your presence. Please permit me to stop at this point, because I know at some point we'll be having introductions of other dignitaries that are here with us this morning. But before I round it up, I'd like to bring very special goodwill, words of consolation and strength from my spiritual father, the president of Living Faith Church Worldwide, in the person of Bishop David Oyepo and his wife, who also endorsed my being here this morning on his behalf. May the church be blessed. Amen. Say loud amen.
Amen.
To the wonderful children of our pastor who just passed on to glory, the Lord will keep you.
Amen.
He is a keeper of Israel. He never sleeps nor slumber. He will keep all of you.
Amen.
All family members, the Lord will keep you.
Amen.
And for the church, no fear, no shaking, because the church belongs to Jesus. He said, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. God can't be building, and the gate of hell will rear his head. What more? God only used his servant, Pastor Taiwo Odukoya, I say this with all respect to him, to found the church. Jesus, the builder, is still awake. And whatsoever he does shall be forever. So this church shall be forever. Oh, I thought somebody saying a loud amen there. I said, this church, as it is with other churches, shall be forever standing strong. Watch it, church. Fresh oil is coming on this church. Fresh grace is coming on this church. Pastor Taiwo finished his work and he left. But the work continues. And the glory of the latter house shall be greater than the former. This church will never know a better yesterday. Another big hand for Jesus. Amen. Now, just as every journey has a start, it also has an end. The starting point of life is birth. That's why we talk about birthday. And the ending point is death. Of course, I don't hear people say death day, but it is real. It's a day. In Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 2, there is time for everything. A time to be born and a time to die. No one can escape it. Ecclesiastes also chapter 7, verses 1 to 4. You wonder why Solomon said this much. He was in pleasure, affluence, but he realized that one day he had to leave. A good name is better than precious ointment, and the day of death is better than the day of one's birth. When one is born, we smile and laugh. When he dies, we cry. Yet the scripture says, the day of death is better than the day of birth. Just like in academic circles, the day of graduation is better than the day of matriculation. Why? Because within the period, so much has been achieved. Came in fresher, now living as graduate. And that's what Pastor Taiwo has experienced. He was matriculated into life. Now he is graduated in glory. Amen. Oh, I thought somebody is excited that he graduated. In line with what Paul said in 2 Timothy chapter 4, from verse 5, he said, I'm about to give up. Now I can see something waiting for me. From verse 6, please. I'm already being poured out as a drink offering. I'm about to evaporate from this world, and the time of my departure is at hand. But the good news is this, I have fought a good fight. I can picture Pastor Taiwo as I'm speaking right now, with a smile, nodding his head, that I'm saying this. I have finished my race, because every start of race has an end. I have kept the faith. Did he keep the faith or not? May you also keep the faith. And in verse 8, he said, finally, there's laid for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous one, will deliver to me that day. This is important because all of us seated there, let no man think that you will extend your time when it comes. Whether you die young or you die old, death is an appointment you have to keep. For it is given unto man. It's appointed unto man to die only once, and after that, the judgment. Hebrews chapter 9, verse 27. Ecclesiastes chapter 8, verse 8, makes it very clear that when your time comes, it doesn't require your view. There is no negotiator with death, because when it comes, it will dominate you and give you no chance to negotiate. Ecclesiastes chapter 8, verse 8. No matter how rich you are, no matter how much treasures you have, no one has power over the spirit to retain the spirit, and no one has power in the day of death. No one has the power. What we do when the time comes is to submit ourselves. Of course, before then, you prepare your home, prepare your work, because there will be no return. It's a journey of no return. There is no probability in death. It is certain. It is not if, it is when. We are all on the line, just waiting for your turn. But not just your turn, but your turn at good old age. Somebody saying a loud amen to that. So we have a space of time that we live, and that's what we call our lifespan. Lifespan, which we have to be sensitive to be able to maximize. In Psalm 90, verse 12, David prayed a tremendous prayer there. So teach us to program our days, not just counting the number, but making the number to count. Teach us to program, to plan, to strategize, to put in more, to invest into our days, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. The big question to all of us this morning is, how wisely are you living? If you are not wise, you are a fool. No third option. If you are wise, you will be thoughtful. You will be investing. You will be advising yourself. I tell people, especially young people, who procrastinate, who say there is time, begin to tell yourself, I am behind time. I am already behind time. That motivates you to work hard. And that's what Pastor Taiwo did. He planned as if he would live forever, but he worked as if he would not see tomorrow. That's where the wisdom comes in. You don't leave your life to chances. Teach us to plan, to program. Our wonderful fathers in the faith are here today, leaving legacies behind. If they were not planning, strategizing, hardworking, we will not be here respecting them today. Every one of us should pick lessons from here today. How wisely am I doing with my time, with my days? I've talked about lifespan, but you see, I want us to also see life beyond your lifespan in two different ways. One, when you are gone, what happens? And when you get to eternity, which is the ultimate destination of your journey, what happens to you there? There are lives that speak after death. Not all who died. They still live. We see their fingerprints. We see their footprints. We see things about them that we cannot forget. And so, as scriptures reveals, there are three things I want to quickly show to us before our time expires, which will continue to bring the memory of Pastor Taiwo to us. And I'd like you to please follow, because we are here today not just being sober about the incidents, but learning from the incidents. Eyes that look are common, eyes that see are few. Ears that hear are common, but ears that perceive are few. Make your eyes this morning a seeing eye. Go home from here with lessons. He has finished his work. He's gone home. But he left lessons for us to learn. The body is going back to the dust, according to Genesis 2:7, 3:19, dust to dust. The spirit, which is eternal, according to Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, is gone to the one who gave it. The soul still relates around with us here. Now, the scripture recognizes three things that a man can be remembered for. Number one, his name. The name. And I want you to begin to ask yourself questions this morning. What name am I leaving behind? The name of man represents honor and respect. There are names you hear today, everybody stands up, even though he's not there. The name of a person represents his personality, his recognition. That's why the scripture describes the name is as ointment. Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 1, we made reference to that earlier. A good name is better than precious ointment. A good name. And a bad name stinks. A good name smells odor. Now, please, let's look at this. I reasoned some times ago, there are great names around the globe who have died. Great musicians, great artists, great sportsmen, but for lack of good character. I've not had people name their children after them. Name is vital. But there are people who you wish you could have more children and give them the name of such individual. Because it's a good name. You either have a good name or a bad name. Sons of Solomon, chapter 1, verse 3. His name is as ointment poured forth. Proverbs chapter 22, verse 1. The name. A good name. The name of a bad man rots, according to scripture. A good name is to be chosen rather than great riches, love and favor than any other thing in life. If you came from a home that values name, they tell you as you are going out, don't spoil the name of the family. Don't spoil the name of the family. Number two thing, we will always remember, based on scriptures concerning Pastor Taiwo, is character. Character. The character he exhibited. Morality, decency, modesty, financial integrity, good public image, not orchestrated by any image, but by genuineness of lifestyle. Today, people have replaced character with other measures. They paint themselves the way they want the world to see them. They do makeup. Wonderful mothers and sisters here this morning. The best time to know you is at night. When the makeup is washed up. That's when your character shows. That's when your true picture is revealed. Not in the morning, going to work. You have treated all the contours that makes you look younger. That's what we call reputation. Reputation may be damaged, but character cannot. Because character cannot die. Character is a person. Reputation is an image. Pastor Taiwo Odukoya, we saw him in his character, in his true image. Even when he was challenged, even though behaved as woman, but never allowed the character of Jesus in him to go down. The integrity of the upright shall uphold him. Psalm 26 verse 11, Proverbs chapter 20 verse 7, the character of a man. This can be summarized in Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 and 23, which unfortunately the church of Jesus is putting at the background today and projecting self-image and reputation. Love, joy, peace, long-suffering when you have been challenged, kindness to all, goodness, faithfulness in the services you are rendering to God and to mankind, gentleness, self-control. And when you do that, no law can work against you. How many of us can see the picture of Pastor Taiwo right now in this scripture? That's how he lived his life. Number three thing you'll be remembered for, which he will be remembered for, is the works done, the virtues impacted. Revelation chapter 14, verse 13. Blessed are those who die in the Lord, for their works will keep speaking after them. Works. Works. That's why I said earlier, not who die, not all who die are actually dead and forgotten. The works left behind. Those who live to self have limited themselves. But those who live for others live forever. They live forever. The greatest investment you make in life is in people. Your car cannot testify of you. Your house cannot write your biography. It is people whom you touch, people whom you impacted, who will keep telling your story in generations to come. It's not the fame. Listen to me. It's not your name on the street. Jesus' name was not on any street, but his impact is all over the globe. Jesus had no national honor to the extent that he was publicly crucified, but people can't forget the impact he made in their lives. Please think people. In the poem read to us this morning, we saw the picture of Pastor Taiwo thinking of people, helping drug addicts, helping helping families, helping young people. How do you think they will forget him? And you know, your works will always bring up back your face to people. Your works will always bring back your memory. That's why it's the memory of the just cannot be forgotten. And that's why, even though Pastor Taiwo has left us, his influence cannot leave us. Which is the reason why virtually everybody was here this morning. From far and near. Some of you left your business. On what account? He influenced your life. He impacted you. Influence don't die. Influence don't die. And influence is a function of impact. The cost price of influence is impact. You may not have a good face, but make impact. And people will color your face as beautiful as they can. They will. Impact. Impact makes you relevant even after your death. Again, influence don't die. Jesus' body was laid in the grave after 33 years, but his influence is speaking into millennia till today. Don't forget your name, your character, your works, your influence, your impact. The great sage of the gospel of the 21st century, Dr. Billy Graham, was once asked, what will you think are the three important, most important things to you? He said, number one, character. Number two, character. Number three, character. If you lose money, you have lost nothing. If you lose your health, you have lost something. But if you lose your character, you have lost everything. Take away character, what remains is carcass. What remains is carcass. Take away character. Do you know character is so important that even thieves who stole money want to hire an accountant who has character? So character will always open doors to you. You lose nothing having good character. For righteousness exalts, but sin is a reproach. Look beautiful, have plenty of money. They say, ole. Because that's how you are, that's who you are. No matter how much you decorate yourself. In closing this morning, let's think of the ultimate destination. There is a place called beyond. After your lifespan, there is somewhere you are going to, which is called eternity. Eternity. That's where Pastor Taiwo is now. That's where no one of us should plan to miss. Eternity. Eternity. How do you assess eternity? Going back home to your father, where you came from. Number one, you must be born again. No alternative. You must. Nicodemus, highly learned. Jesus said to him, thank you for your accolade, but you must be born again. You must, no alternative. You must be born again. The key to eternity is new birth. You don't have it? I don't mean to use any harsh word, but you are going to eternal damnation. That's what Jesus said. That's what the scripture, you either surrender to Jesus or you go to eternal damnation. Wherever you are this morning, please think about it. Soon, you'll be in a coffin. Soon, they will not take you back to your bedroom. Soon, your car will be lying fallow. Soon, you won't find anybody opening any door for you again. It will happen. It's only a matter of time. Think about your life. Where will you spend eternity? As I'm speaking right now, my spirit, the spirit of God, is telling me somebody is here who needs to make that decision. You need to make the decision. The wine you used to drink, the man or the woman you used to carry, one day they won't move close to you again. I have not seen any living kissing the dead. Where will you spend eternity? Number two, have a testimony of walking with God. Develop closer relationship with God. That's why Ecclesiastes said, it is better to go to the house of mourning than the house of celebration. He said, because your heart will draw close, that your time is coming. You are getting closer. One day after another, you are getting closer. You are getting closer. Getting closer. Make your decisions very fast. Draw close to God. Because if you don't draw close to Him today, you will still meet Him one day, but not in the closer range again. Enoch walked with God, and he was taken. He was taken. Well, I want to pray. The Spirit of God tells me I must pray for someone here this morning who will make a decision. Never late to make that decision. Pastor Taiwo is with Jesus, not because he was a pastor, but because he gave his life to Jesus. Salvation is more important than ministry. Destiny is more important than any calling. You are first saved before you are called. Called to salvation before called to ministry. I tell people, I would rather be off ministry and not miss heaven. I want to be there. I want to be where Pastor Taiwo is right now. I love his smile. I want to meet it again, which represents the smile of Jesus. If you are here this morning and you are not born again, permit me to tell you with all politeness, your coming is wasted. There may be a place for you loving our pastor, but you can't get to where he is. Just like the rich man couldn't get to where Abraham and Lazarus was, except you are born again. Let me request all of us, please, in honor of Jesus, let's bow our heads. Somebody is saying, Pastor, please pray for me. I understand what you have said. I want to give my life to Jesus. Wherever you are, I want to pray for you. I know the Spirit of God is talking to you now. You can't doubt it because you know it in your heart. I want to be born again. I want to give my life to Jesus. Let me ask you to just lift up your right hand so I can pray with you. I don't want to miss this, and I don't want you to miss it. Wherever you are, on the gallery, on the ground floor here, in between, I want to give my life to Jesus. If you raise your hand, please stand to your feet, signifying that you are standing for Jesus. God bless you. God bless you. If you are doing that, God bless you. And if you do, the officials will check on you, share some thoughts with you. Those who may have risen, pray this prayer with me, very simple. Say with me, Lord Jesus, please have mercy on me. I know I'm a sinner. I want to surrender my life to you. I want to be born again. I want to make heaven. I don't want to miss eternity. Give me new life. Give me your joy and peace. Give me your salvation. Write my name in the book of life. And at your second coming, I will not miss heaven. In Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, we thank you again for this morning. Let me ask you to please, everybody, rise to your feet and let's give thanks to God. And I'd like you to pray, Lord, give me the order of testimony with good name, with good character, with good works, that I will leave behind when my time is up, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father, and all the saints of God in the house, please say a loud amen. Amen. Give God a big hand, please. And please be seated.
Hallelujah. Thank you so very much, sir, for those wonderful words of wisdom. Hallelujah. We're going to be privileged to watch a short video, and thereafter there will be a special song rendition by our songstress, Pastor Mrs. Tolu Odukoya. First we'll watch a video, then Pastor Tolu will come up and give a special song, and thereafter the choir will take us through two renditions. Thank you very much. The video. Hallelujah. I'm not sure what has happened to the video, but you can watch it in the spirit. My dear sister, are you ready for us? Hallelujah. Please put your hands together for Pastor Tolu.
Hallelujah. It's a simple song of how I believe my father lived. Change the key. I've lost my voice. Stop pressing the piano. He loved you, Lord, for your mercy never failed him. All his days, he was wrapped in your hands. From the moment that he woke to when he laid his head, oh, he sang of the goodness of God. He knew your voice, oh, you held him through the fire in darkest nights. You were close like no other. He knew you as a father. He knew you as a friend. Oh, he lived in the goodness of God. All his life you were so faithful. So good. With every breath that he was able, oh, he sang of the goodness of God. Your goodness kept running after, it kept running after him. Your goodness kept running after him. With his life laid down, he surrendered. Oh, he gave you everything. Your goodness kept running after him. Your goodness kept running after, kept running after him. With his life laid down, he surrendered all. He gave. so, so good. With every breath that he was able, oh, he said, of the goodness of God. Hallelujah.
You'll never forget that there's a pastor in Fountain. His name is not Taiwo. Taiwo is a delegated authority. The pastor of Fountain is the Holy Spirit. I hope you know that.
There's nothing you get from God that is not made manifest only by the Spirit. In the name of Jesus, yes, and he releases it. He executes the promise, but he leaves it for the Holy Spirit to reveal to you.
And that's why we are very confident. Did you hear me say it? We are very, very confident of the ministry and the person and the power of the Holy. Of the Holy Spirit. Someone shall Holy Ghost. Someone shall Holy Spirit. Your place. Say Holy Ghost. Thank you. And please help me remind him. Say Holy Spirit. Please remember. You are the pastor of Fountain of Life Church. Say it again. Say it one more time. Settled. In Jesus' name.
Let's give God some praise this afternoon. Let someone shout a big hallelujah. No, that's not enough. Let's shout a bigger hallelujah. If Pastor Taiwo has touched your life, shout a bigger hallelujah. We give God praise. Hallelujah. You may please be seated. We're gradually getting to the close of this service. Just a few announcements before we close. First of all, we would like to thank everyone for your time, how you have been with us at this very difficult moment. The Bible says that though our hearts ache, we still have joy in our hearts. And we really, really thank you. It is so, so important to us. We are really glad in our hearts that you've made out time to be with us. Even before this time, thank you so much. I want you to appreciate everyone next to you. Just say thank you to them. Everyone sitting next to you, say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Would like to recognize a few people here this afternoon. We are all very important. Because of time, we can't recognize everybody. But we know that you are with us, and we know that you've contributed immensely to the success of this program. First of all, we'd like to thank our grandparents in the Lord. Honestly, when you know you have somebody who is behind you, thank you, Bishop Mike and Bishop Peace Okonkwo, for your tireless work, for always being there for us. We thank you so much. That was a fantastic word in time and in season by Bishop David Abioye. We will never forget name, character, and works. And please give our regards to Bishop Oyedepo. Thank you so much. Thank you, Pastor Matthew Ashimolowo, for taking out time to be with us. Our Excellency, Pastor Dolapo Oshibajo, thank you. The Right Reverend Dr. Babatunde Abiodun Taiwo, the Secretary of Conference Methodist Church of Nigeria, thank you. Bishop Taiwo Adulakun, thank you. Pastor Wale Adifarasin, we thank you. Pastor and Mrs. Tony Rapo, we thank you. Our Reverend and Pastor Mrs. Yomi Oyinloye, the Assistant GO of First Choir, we thank you for being with us. Commodore Olofimoye, former Governor of Ogun State, thank you for being with us. Pastor Additional, thank you for being with us. Pastor's very good friend, Pastor Claire Mesemoe, thank you for being with us. All the various pastors here that we can't mention, we know some of you are hiding in the crowd. We really love you and we thank you for your time, for being with us at this time. God will bless you. We can see the delegation from Cannes, Lagos. God bless you for being with us. Thank you so much. And all the fountaineers, good, good, great fountaineers, applaud yourselves. Fountain is a great church. Is a great place to be. You are great guys. We love you. And you know, the Lord be with you in Jesus' name. All the pastors of the Fountain of Life Church, everywhere, thank you. The choir, thank you for what you've done. The Grace Band, the ushers, the protocol, the different departments that you have served. God bless you. Real good. Other announcements. The interment is private, so if you've not been invited, don't make your way there because you will not be allowed to come in. So it's private. Then there was a guard of honor when the body of pastor came into church. If you are that part of that guard of honor, we're still having a guard of honor for him. So just before the recessional hymn, please, you can please form the guard of honor. The order of exit will be those who came in with a coffin would also be those who would go out. Please stay in the service until the choir finishes singing the recessional hymn. Finally, the Thanksgiving service is tomorrow morning, Sunday, 10 a.m., one service. 10 a.m., one service. The Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Shall we rise for the recessional hymn? And just before, and as we rise for the recessional hymn, there was something Pastor made part of every service. And I would want us to recite it just before we leave. And that is, for the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set us free from the law of sin and death. And so Satan shall not have dominion over us. For the same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells inside of us and quickens our mortal bodies to the glory of his holy name. Amen. Hallelujah. Just before we go, we're going to shout three wonderful hallelujahs, and we know that God has done great things. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord! Just 30 seconds for the guard of honor to form before we have the recessional hymn. Can we have the guard of honor? And we thank all those who are watching online. We see you. Thank you. Over 16,000 of you. God bless you. Please let the family go out before we start to leave.
bless the Lord. Hallelujah, look, finish from my mouth. Hallelujah, look, finish from my mouth. Oh, praise the Lord, cannot finish from my tongue. Hallelujah, look, finish from my mouth. Would you help me sing it? He knows we'll finish. Oh, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, look, finish from my mouth. Hallelujah, let go finish. Hallelujah, let go finish. Hallelujah, let go. Hallelujah, let go finish. Hallelujah, let go finish. What do you say?
Hallelujah,
let go
finish. Hallelujah,
let
go finish. Hallelujah,
hallelujah,
let go finish.
Hallelujah,
let go finish.
Oba to ba da ba le